नमस्ते, आई एम जेवीएन डॉक्टर सुरेंद्र कुमार श्रीवास्तव फ्रॉम द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ साइंस अंडर द फैकल्टी ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड मेथोडोलॉजी ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। टुडे आई विल सी सम थ्योरम्स ऑन फाइनाइट इंटीग्रल डोमेन। फर्स्ट थ्योरम इज एवरी फाइनाइट इंटीग्रल डोमेन इज ए फील्ड। फॉर प्रूफ लेट डी कमा प्लस कमा डॉट बी ए फाइनाइट इंटीग्रल डोमेन सो दैट डी कमा प्लस इज एन अबेलियन ग्रुप। सेकेंड डी कमा डॉट इज ए सेमी ग्रुप। थर्ड डी हैज यूनिटी। फोर्थ डी इज कम्यूटेटिव। फाइव डी हैज नो जीरो डिवाइजर्स। एंड सिक्स द टू डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन लॉ होल्ड्स इन कैपिटल डी। Our aim to show that capital D is a field. From 5, cancellation law holds in capital D. Since D is finite and hence capital D contains a finite number, say n, of elements. Let these elements be x1, x2, x3 and so on xn, that is capital D is equal to capital D is such that x1, x2, x3 and so on a, and so on an, xn. Let a belongs to D be arbitrary such that capital A is not, small a is not 0, then ax1, ax2, ax3 and so on axn also belongs to D. Therefore, the same n elements x1, x2, x3 and so on xn, but in different order xi, xj belongs to capital D such that axi is equal to axj. Axi is equal to axj, that implies a in bracket xi minus xj is equal to 0. D is free from 0 divisor, that implies xi minus xj is equal to 0, that implies xi is equal to xj. Thus we have proof axi is equal to axj, that implies xi is equal to xj, or equivalently xi is not equal to xj, that implies axi is not equal to axj. Hence, ax1, ax2 and so on axn belongs to capital D are all distinct elements. Capital D contains unity element, that implies 1 belongs to capital D. That implies there exist axp belongs to capital D such that axp is equal to 1. But capital D is commutative, that implies axp is equal to xpa is equal to 1. That implies a inverse belongs to D. That implies D has multiplicative inverse in capital D. Thus we have shown that every non-zero element of capital D has multiplicative inverse in capital D, that is D is field. Now we see the another theorem. The characteristics of a ring with unity is 0 or n is greater than 0 according as the unit element E regarding as the member of addition group of capital R of order 0 or n. If capital R is any ring with identity 1, so that capital R has positive characteristic n if and only if n is the least positive integer for which n dot 1 is equal to 0, 0 being additive identity of capital R. Let capital R be a ring with unity element E, order of E is equal to 0, that implies characteristics of R is 0. Suppose order of E is equal to n is equal to a finite number so that n is the least positive integer such that n is equal to e. Let a be the any element of capital R, then na is equal to n a replaced by ea, for ea is equal to a is equal to ae, that implies ne is equal to a, that implies 0a is equal to 0. Thus n is the least positive integer such that na is equal to 0. By definition, this proves that the characteristics of R is n. Next theorem, every finite integral domain capital D of finite characteristics. Let capital D comma plus comma dot be a finite integral domain so that D comma plus is a finite abelian group. We also know that characteristics of capital D is the order of element E of D comma plus. D comma plus is finite group, that implies order of E is equal to finite. That implies characteristics of capital D is finite. Now the next theorem, the characteristic of an integral domain is either 0 or a prime number according as the unit element E regarding as a member of the additive group of integral domain is of order 0 or a prime number. For proving let capital D is an integral domain, then capital D is an integral domain with identity element E. Suppose order of E is equal to n. This is the finite number so that n is the least positive integer such that n e is equal to 0. Let a be any element of capital D, then n a is equal to n in bracket e a, for e a is equal to a e is equal to n e a is equal to 0 a is equal to 0. Thus n is the least positive integer such that n a is equal to 0. By definition, this proves that the characteristic of capital D is n. For the second, if the characteristic is 0, the proof is complete. Let the characteristic be p is greater than 0. We have to show that p is a prime number. Suppose p is not prime, then p is composite integer. So we can write p is equal to p1 into p2, where 1 is less or equal less than p1 and p2 is less than p. Characteristic of D is p, that implies order of E of the group D comma plus is p, that implies order of E is equal to p, that implies p is equal to 0, that implies p1 p2 e is equal to 0, that implies p1 in bracket p2 e is equal to 0, that implies p1 e p2 e is equal to 0. So p1 e is equal to 0 or p2 e is equal to 0, for D has no zero divisors. That implies characteristics of capital D is either p1 or p2 is less than p. That implies characteristic of D is less than p, a contradiction. Hence p is not composite, therefore p is prime. Thank you.